Muhammad, question from the email says, in the hadith, it is mentioned that building anything over the grave is forbidden. Then why were there tombs on the Prophet ﷺ and the companions' graves in Jannatul Baqi' before 1925 demolition? I wasn't born on 1925, akhi, so I cannot get any comment on this. And I personally don't believe everything that is mentioned in history. I'm a Muslim. Ask me about Quran, about Sunnah. But anything else, I fail to reciprocate because I have no knowledge in it. First of all, what does the Sunnah clearly state about building tombs over graves? So we will take the knowledge from Quran and Sunnah rather than the books of history. We find that the Prophet والسلام, in the hadith is in Sahih Imam Muslim, Abu al-Hayyaj al-Asadi, one of the Tabi'een, said, Ali ibn Abi Talib, the cousin of the Prophet والسلام, and his son-in-law, and the fourth caliph, may Allah be pleased with him, said to him that, shall I dispatch you to do the things that the Prophet told me to do, alayhi salam? So now Ali is relaying the advice and the command of the Prophet ﷺ to his companion. What was it? Ali says, the Prophet ﷺ told me not to see a picture or a surah or a statue without dismantling it, to destroying it, disfiguring it, so that it would not become a picture or a statue, and not to leave any grave that is above the ground without leveling it. This is the hadith in Sahih Imam Muslim, no doubt about it. When the Prophet died, Mother Aisha told us that one of the last words the Prophet said was, may Allah curse the Jews and the Christians for taking the graves of their prophets as houses of worship. So the Prophet is warning us not to follow suit and not to take the graves of our Prophet as a house of worship. Aisha comments and says, had he not said that, we would have showed his grave and built something on top of it. But they didn't do that. So let's go and check. Where was the Prophet buried, alayhi salatu wasalam? Unanimously, no Muslim would differ. He was buried in the house of Aisha. So was he buried in the masjid? No. The house of Aisha was adjacent to the masjid, but it was out of it. The Prophet used to sleep in that house, have intimacy with his wives. So he wasn't definitely in the masjid. It was outside of the masjid. Okay. Who was buried in the house of Aisha? Abu Bakr and Umar. So all were buried in the house of Aisha. So at the time of Abu Bakr, was the house included in the masjid? Nope. At the time of Umar? Nope. At the time of Uthman? Nope. At the time of Ali? Nope. At the time of Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan? Nope. Yazid ibn Muawiyah, Abdul Malik ibn Marwan? No. Until the year 88 of Hijrah, the house was separated from the masjid. Until Al-Walid ibn Abdul Malik, who was the Khalifa at the time, issued a directive to the ruler of Medina. And by the way, who was the ruler of Medina? Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, the great caliph, the just caliph of Bani Umayyah. So he ordered him to expand the masjid and include the houses of the wives of the Prophet ﷺ inside of the masjid to expand it. So he gathered the people of Medina. There were no companions. This was the era of Tabi'een, Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib and the others. And he consulted them and said, what should I do? They all opposed it and said, no, this is not permissible. This is prohibited. So he wrote back to the caliph, Al-Walid ibn Abdul Malik, and he said, the scholars of Medina say that this is haram. This is not permissible. Do you think that the ruler would listen to them? Definitely not. He's got the police, he's got the army, he's got the air force. So he could not even care of what they had said. He said, Simon says, do it. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz had no other choice but to do it. And he demolished the area with the Qibla, and he included the grave of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, because all the houses of the wives were demolished, and then he expanded the masjid. So you tell me, is this part of Islam? One would argue, okay, why not re-demolish it again and get the grave outside of the masjid? Subhanallah, do you think that the Muslim world are equipped to understand or comprehend? The Prophet himself, alayhi salatu wasalam, said to Mother Aisha, had it not been that your people were recently idol worshippers, I would have demolished the Kaaba and I would have built it on the foundations of Ibrahim, and I would have made two doors for it, a door that people get into and the door that a people would exit from. Why didn't the Prophet do it, alayhi salatu wasalam? Because he feared that the people who were recently mushrik will turn again back to shirk and abandon Islam if they see such a thing. Nowadays, any government that would even think of doing such a thing, it would be damned as a kafir government or authority. So this is exactly following the sunnah, so that people would not manipulate and play around with the message of the Prophet ﷺ. So follow the Quran and follow the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ and that of his companions, and neglect and ignore those grave worshippers who promote building over the graves against the teachings of the Prophet ﷺ and call people to glorify it and to offer sacrifice for it. And Allah Azza wa Jal knows best.